Hey there, Service Pros. This is Christian from the Workiz product team. In this video, we're going to talk about how to manage multiple service areas within Workiz. Between booking jobs in areas your company actually serves and then assigning those jobs to the right field techs who service that area, the life of a new dispatcher can be difficult. We totally get it. At Workiz, we aim to fix that with service areas. This add-on makes booking new jobs easy for dispatchers, never letting them wonder whether your company should take the job or if anybody on your team is actually capable of completing that job. Whether you need this add-on right now is up to you, but as your business grows and starts to expand into other areas, managing service areas with this Workiz add-on is a must. Let's get started. To start using service areas, we'll need to enable the add-on from the marketplace. Go ahead and select the marketplace from the navigation bar up here. We'll scroll down to the add-on section and select service areas right here. All we need to do is turn this toggle switch on to activate the add-on. Once we do that, we'll need to get to the service areas settings page. We can do that pretty easily by selecting this button right here, but let's show you how to get there from the settings page for future use. Go ahead and select settings from the navigation bar up here and select settings. Under job settings, select service areas. Next, we'll select the add service area button over here. There's two ways to create a service area in Workiz, a basic service area and an advanced one. Let's go over the basic one first. It's gonna ask you for a few things here. We'll need a name for the service area. We'll call ours South San Diego. Next, we'll need a zip code. It's best to choose one that is more or less at the center of this service area. We'll go with 91911. After that, we'll need a mile radius. This essentially creates a circle around that zip code we entered. The higher the number you enter, the bigger the circle will get. I'll go ahead and enter 20. We'll quickly choose a color and then decide the tax rate we want to use for the service area so that our estimates and invoices are automatically taxed appropriately. I already have tax rates in my account, so I'll choose Chula Vista. For more information on how to add a tax rate, feel free to check out the link in the description below. If you're happy with the basic service area, hit save and then you're done. It should work wonders for you. But let's quickly take a look at how to create an advanced one. We'll hit this toggle switch right here to expand those settings. You should see a map pop up on the right side of your screen. First thing we'll need to do is enter the name of the city we want to create a service area in. We'll enter Chula Vista, California. From here, we can create an exact boundary for the area we want to serve. We'll select this button right here to enable the boundary creation mode. After that, we'll want to hover our cursor over the edges of the service area we want to create. Click to drop a boundary point and then continue clicking along the shape you want to create for your service area. You'll want to make sure you close off the area in order for it to register, just like this. And quick pro tip, if you want to close off the shape at any time, just double click with your mouse. Hit save once you're done. After that, you'll want to repeat the process until you have all your service areas set up. Now let's quickly take a look at a team member's profile page so we can see how service areas can come into play when adding a new job. From that team member's profile page, we'll want to add all the service areas they're capable of performing jobs in. And now to add a new job. Once you enter the service address for this client, Workiz will automatically assign this job to the nearest service area you have in your account. And if it's not an exact match, Workiz will also let you know how far this address is from your nearest service area, so that you can quickly make a decision on whether to book this job or not. Better yet, Workiz will also notify dispatchers with a list of field techs who can work in this service area, so that they never have to wonder who can be assigned to a new job again. Okay, one last topic, but it's a pretty big topic. Once you have service areas all set up, Workiz will provide you with valuable data on which areas are performing well for your business. Head over to the job statistics report, and within the area performance tab, you'll see all kinds of useful information broken down by service area. Things like the number of jobs booked, the number of jobs canceled, the cancellation rate, the total amount of profit, and the average profit amount. Lots of good stuff here. All right, that's all we've got for service areas in this video. Feel free to subscribe to this channel for all the latest on how Workiz can help improve your growing business. And as always, if you have any questions, we're here to help. Thanks for watching.